I don't know if I recall.
In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can set up a recall box on your own Raspberry Pi. And it's going to include all the trimmings, so make sure you stick around, because you know what time it is. Hey guys, Jonathan here with TechWizTime, where I teach you technology through tutorials. And today, I'm going to show you how you can set up a recall box on your Raspberry Pi, and it's going to include everything like how to transfer ROMs, how to set up the whole system, the whole shebang. But before we go any further, make sure you like this video and share it with your friends, because sharing really does help this channel, and it's like you're giving me a dollar every single time you share this video. I know I've said it before, but it really is worth that much to me. So I just want to say thank you so much in advance for sharing this video. And with that said, let's jump over to the computer quickly and we'll see how we can install recalbox on the micro SD card. Just quickly, I have also done other videos here on how to set up RetroPie in this same format and Lakka. So if you do want to see those videos, make sure you hit up there for the playlist where you can see how to do it yourself. Okay, so the first thing we're going to want to do is go to recalbox.com. Once the web page is loaded, we'll go up to DIY recalbox menu up the top and we'll scroll down to number 2 section and we'll click on the GitHub link. Once we're on the GitHub releases page, we'll go and we'll download the zip file so we can put this on our micro SD card. So the first thing that we're going to want to do is to extract this zip file to a folder. And to do that, we'll use a program like 7-Zip. Once it's extracted, we'll go into that folder and copy all the files and then paste them directly into the micro SD card that we're going to put into our Raspberry Pi. Once that's finished copying across, what we'll do is we'll eject the micro SD card and we'll pop it into our Raspberry Pi. So now that we've got recalbox installed onto the micro SD card, what we'll do is we'll jump over to the Raspberry Pi now and we'll see how we do the rest. So on our first boot of recalbox, it will go through and change the partitions and sizes and so forth and install a few things. So this will take a little while, so bear with it. But what you can do is, if you like, while it's installing, you can change your language options down the bottom. And in my case, I'm changing it from Great Britain to US. This just means that my keyboard is set up for my keyboard structure. So after that it's finally completed, it will reboot and it will come back up with the recalbox main screen. And if you leave it for a little while here and it is connected to a network, it will come up letting you know, if there is one available, that there is an update available. And that's the first thing that we'll tackle here right now. One other thing that I will mention is that I am using an Xbox 360 USB controller here. So what we do is we press start on the controller and we go down to system settings and we go down to the bottom to update. In here we go down to start update and it will ask us if we really want to update. So we'll say yes. Now be prepared to wait a few minutes here. Mine took about 3 or 4 minutes on a fairly decent connection. So if you have a slower connection, then this may take a while. Eventually it will tell you that the update is downloaded and the system will need to reboot. So hit OK here and it will go through its reboot and updating process. Now you may notice here that mine is on version 4.0.1 and we'll take note of that and we'll see what it updates to. So this will reboot a couple of times, but eventually it will come to a screen where up in the top left hand corner it has a percentage counter there to let you know that it's running. So eventually it will reboot one last time and it will come up and say it's version 4.0.2. And when it does come back up to recalbox, it will let you know what the update was for. And in this case it was to fix something with the NES. Okay, so now that we have updated the system, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to transfer some ROMs across. But to do that first, we need to go into the start menu and go into the networking settings down the very bottom. Now in here, you'll see that it's connected via Ethernet at the moment. There's our IP address and also the host name, which is recalbox. Now, if you are looking to use a Wi-Fi connection, this is where you would set that up. So take note of both your IP address and your host name. And now what we'll do is we'll jump over to the computer and we'll look at how we can transfer ROMs across to recalbox. So in a Windows Explorer window, what we'll do is we'll type in the address bar, /, and the host name, which was recalbox, all capital letters. Now, if this doesn't work for you, this is where you would type in /, your IP address. So what should happen after a little bit is it will prompt you for credentials. And this is where we'll type in the username and password for recalbox, which is root and recalbox root. So username root and the password is recalbox root. Hit OK and it should load up with a share folder. Double click on that and you'll see a lot of folder structures in here. What we're going to do is we're going to go into the ROMs folder and in my circumstance going into Super Nintendo. Now I'm going to copy across a childhood favorite of mine, which was Uni Rally, or Uni Races. So I'll copy the ROM into the Super Nintendo folder. Now before we get too excited, I'm going to show you another method which you could use on any system, not just Windows. And that is through a web browser. So we'll open up a web browser and in the address bar we'll type in either recalbox.local or the IP address that we wrote down before. And this will bring up the management screen for recalbox. Now here we can check on things like monitoring, where we can see our CPU usage, memory, and also how much space we've got left. We can also check out and upload BIOSes in this section here. A quick tip for anyone asking, if you do need to find a BIOS, especially for those people out there that don't have the hardware to dump their own system's BIOSes, you could try Googling the MD5 checksum name. And one of the most important places is the ROM section. And here you can actually see inside the Super Nintendo section that I've already uploaded the UniRally ROM. One of the great things about this management tool as well is that you can actually put a check beside any of these and remove them. So it's a really good management tool. And if you need to upload a ROM, you can just drag and drop it onto the web page in the section up the top there. Now, one last bonus here. This is for people that may not have an Xbox 360 controller, but still want to use it. So say, for example, you've got an Android or an Apple iPhone, or even an iPad for that matter. If you can get into your web browser and connect to this manager, then you can click on the virtual controller. And what you've got now is you've got a touchscreen controller for your recalbox installation. Some people don't like the feeling of a virtual gamepad, some people do, so this is purely subjective. It's if you like it or if you don't. But the option is there for those people that want to use it. Awesome! And for those people out there that want to use SSH with a tool like PuTTY, you can log in with the username root and the password recalbox root, and you've got SSH access to your recalbox installation. Now, before the ROMs will actually show up on your system, you will need to do a quick reboot, so make sure you've done that first. But now if we have a look in the Super Nintendo folder, you'll see there that it doesn't have any of the metadata or game images there. So what I'm going to show you now is how to scrape all that information for your ROMs. So if we go onto the start menu and go all the way down to Scraper, and here we choose Scrape Now, and you've got a few options there that you can play around with if you want. If you're not too sure, just go down and hit Start. This will go through and scrape not only the ones that you've just uploaded, but also any ones that it hasn't found before. And in this case, there are a few public domain ROMs attached to these systems by default. So it will go through and try and find those. If you're not too keen, just hit Skip. And now when we have a look in Super Nintendo, we can see there that it scraped the information for the UniRally game. And we'll just start it up and just see how it runs. And it's not quite as good as I remember when I was a kid, but it's still a pretty fun game. Now, one other thing that you may want to use with this system, which is installed already, is Kodi. And to access that, you go through the start menu and you go down to Kodi. So this is on the older 15.2 version of Kodi. And unfortunately, at this stage, that's as good as you're going to get with Recalbox. There is updates apparently planned for 4.1, but that's a little while off yet. So if you're happy with 15.2, then this is ready for you out of the box. Awesome, so now we've got Recalbox set up on the Raspberry Pi and it's running, you've got ROMs on there and you can play to your heart's content. That is your retro gaming system right there in a little nutshell. How awesome is that? So did I miss a step here, or is there something that you want me to cover that I didn't cover in this tutorial video, or even another tutorial that you want me to do? Leave me a comment down below and let me know, because I really do take note of all your comments. Even if I can't get to every single one of you. Yeah, you know who you are. Yeah. Make sure you subscribe to this channel because I do release new videos twice every week. And if you are a subscriber already, make sure you hit that bell icon because you'll get notified whenever I do release a new video and you can see what my topics are. Thanks again and imagine, learn, create.